Welcome to the fourth chapter of PHP FPDF tutorial series. In this chapter, I'm about to demonstrate how to put data from database into PDF, and how to represent data in printable PDF pages. In this tutorial, we will utilize header and footer from previous chapter. And we will also learn how to set page break, deal with overflowing content. I have prepared some random dummy data which contain list of clients with phone, email, and address. The data is stored in mysql table and database. In order to trigger page break, we need a lot of data, so here I've prepared 200 of them. First, we need to make database connection. Next, remove unnecessary lines from previous chapter. Now we need to make the page and table heading inside header function, so it will be repeated on each pages. Here I use set draw color and set fill color to make it prettier. And add true as cell 7th parameter to apply background color into the cell. Let's leave the footer for later and jump to the content. Just as usual, make a database query, then iterate the result into cells. As you can see here, the content is automatically broke when reaching end of page. The default page break is 2 cm from the bottom of page. To change that, we can use set auto page break method. Here, I set it to 15 mm. Now, as we can see here, the overflowing text is overlap into next cell. There are many options to deal with that. The easiest way is to truncate the content, but it will conceal the rest of the information. I will explain how to deal with overflowing text in another chapter. This time, because the text is only overflowed a little, we can just shrink it to fit the cell. We can utilize getStringWidth method to see if the text will overflow the cell and let logic do the rest. Now let's make the table looks better. Use only left and right border for contents cell. And finally put dummy cell in footer to close the table. This concludes this chapter of tutorial. Thank you for watching. See you in the next chapter.